we are back.
Hi.
And we're doing...
yet another test.
Another theater video because
what else would we do?
All the videos I do with Olivia are theater related.
We kind of match and I like it. Anyways.
Yeah, we didn't even plan this and we just match. We're doing the Dear Evan Hansen tag.
We made it up ourselves. What's your favorite song in Act 1?
Requiem and I like For Forever.
I'm gonna have to go with like probably If I Could Tell Her or Disappear. Act 2.
Okay, I have 3. And they're like all after each other. Good For You. Words Fail. And So Big So Small.
Only Us, So Big So Small. Favorite male and female character.
Okay, so I like Jared. Cause it's Will Roland. And then Heidi Hansen. Cause I feel like over the whole show, like, she's the most developed character.
As much as I love Connor, I realize that Evan's fake Connor is not the real Connor, so I have to pick Evan for my favorite male character. But I don't hate Jared or Larry, and I like Zoe a lot. I really like Heidi, but I like Zoe too. Zoe has a really special place in my heart.
Who would you like to play? Heidi Hansen!
Heidi Hansen or Zoe? Or Alana, or Cynthia, or
any of the females.
Favorite cast member?
Well, Roland.
Laura, because of the Fruit Snacks videos on her story.
I really like Will Roland, and I like Will. He looks like Ziggy from Lazy Town.
Which two or three of the actors have the best on or off stage chemistry?
Laura and Ben.
They're so good. I love them. Most overrated song.
Waving Through a Window.
Sincerely Me. Everyone likes Sincerely Me, and I do like it, but it's not the best. Least appreciated song.
I'm gonna say Good For You because, I don't know, I feel like nobody talks about that song.
Everyone really hates To Break in a Glove. But honestly, that song is exactly what Evan needed. First of all, Evan needed a dad. He's like Percy Jackson, but with more problems. Really, I listened to it after I found out that it got a lot of hate, so I went into it thinking, oh, it was gonna be awful. But then it actually wasn't, and I really like it. And like, Larry didn't know that what he was saying was making Evan think about lying and his entire life. Most overrated character.
Evan Hansen.
Connor Murphy.
He's not even in it that much.
Yeah, I know, but he's really overrated. Like, people only talk about Connor.
I mean, Evan Hansen is the title character, so I feel like that automatically just makes him overrated.
Least appreciated character? Alana.
Yeah.
Yeah, no one talks about her ever.
Or Cynthia.
Yeah, I love Cynthia. What is one thing you would change?
Some of the cut songs should not have been cut.
Yeah. Biggest pet peeves about the show in general?
I don't know.
The fan culture. Hold on a second.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your public service announcement. Connor Murphy was not secretly dating Evan Hansen. Evan Hansen is in fact, or was in fact, dating his sister, Zoe Murphy. One thing I would change about this show in general is the fact that no one remembers that, and by trying to pair two guys together who literally talk for like, what, 5 minutes tops, by trying to pair them, you negate everything that Zoe does for Evan, and you therefore give Connor a pass on all of his abusive behavior to literally everyone. I think I would change the fan culture.
Because it's not okay to make light of mental illnesses, kids.
I think I would change the ending because I just want...
I like it. I like that Evan
I just want Zoe
himself.
And Evan to be
but
together.
But I want them to be together. I like that she was good for him. Like,
good for you.
Yeah, no, like she was actually good for him. She made him feel better and like that he could be loved because he didn't feel like that with Heidi, even though he was ultimately loved by Heidi. Do you like Zoe?
Yeah. Yes.
I love Zoe Murphy. She's not perfect, but literally no one in this show is perfect. Like, people pretend that Evan is perfect.
Everyone is flawed.
Every single character is flawed.
What are your thoughts on Heidi Hansen? I think she is kind of misunderstood. I mean, like, she's a busy mom, and people don't think that she cares for Evan. Or Evan, and Evan doesn't think that she cares for Evan, but she does. She just is trying to make a living, trying to get money so he can go to college. And I think throughout the musical, she has the biggest change, because at the end, she finally tells Evan, like, you know, like, when you need help, I'll be here. I'm not leaving. Yeah. She finally says what she's been trying to say all along, but instead of saying it and showing it, she worked more to say that I'll be here for you. But now she's actually there for him.
What are your thoughts on Connor Murphy? Oh, boy.
I mean, you don't really know that much about him.
Yeah, because there are some deleted songs.
And, like, everything that we know about him isn't true.
I think that he is misrepresented, as I've touched on before, because
yes.
It makes me upset that he is not shown to be who he really is.
Yeah, he's only known to what Evan says.
I think that he was a terrible person, but also a very hurt and broken person, and it's never too late for anyone. I get really emotional about these characters because this is something that I like try to preach every single day of my life. Go check out the Everyone Project and you'll find out what I mean. Even if Connor had been real, like, his life mattered. And I feel like that was something he should have been told more. I feel like everyone needs to be told that they matter. Which is why I like this show so much. What are your thoughts on the Murphys? Sorry, let's make this a little bit lighter. It's not gonna get any lighter. Thoughts on the Murphys?
Again, I don't think you know that much about them.
Yeah.
Other than Larry seems like he was a supporting father because he was like, I don't know, he just seems like he was. Because he had like,
he had plans for Connor that Connor didn't like, and the fans see that and they only see what Connor sees. They're like,
but he seemed like he really cared. And
he just didn't care in the way that Connor needed to care. What are your thoughts on Jared and Alana?
Jared is funny.
Like, I like Jared a lot.
I do really enjoy Jared's character. And I just like Will Roland as a person. Alana, you don't really get to know her. Like, she's just kind of there.
She also suffers from an anxiety disorder,
I think.
And people don't talk about it because they only talk about Evan. And that's not good. Her disorder is just as unfortunate as Evan's, ladies and gents. Mm-hmm. Question 18. Do you think Evan and Zoe could get back together? Hypothetically.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think it's gonna be one of those things, like, where they, like, take a break for a little while because they're like, oh,
take a break.
Yeah. And but I think personality-wise, like, yeah, Zoe was very hurt by Evan. Evan was very hurt by himself. That's not good. But I think they would work very well. Oh, what's the most hype song in Act 1?
Either
Sincerely Me.
Yeah.
Sincerely Me.
Sincerely Me.
Or Waving Through a Window.
Yeah.
Yes. Most hype song in Act 2.
Does hype mean like, what does that mean?
Like hype, pump you up.
Oh.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Yeah, I think that's it.
It's my jam.
Or Sincerely Me Reprise. What's the saddest song in Act 1?
Requiem.
Act 2.
So big, so small.
So big, so small.
Or Words Fail.
Or when you listen to the whole thing and you know that Evan and Zoe break up. You go back and listen to Only Us and you realize that Zoe was totally willing to accept Evan with all of his problems except for the one problem that was the reason that they didn't work out.
Yeah.
That was sad for me because I liked them because I liked that she was helping him. How did you find out about it?
Okay, so story
she
time.
She actually has a story.
Yeah, I do. So, my mom was driving to work one day. We listened to the same radio station in the morning. And she comes home from work. And I come home from school. And she's like, oh my gosh, like, have you heard of Dear Evan Hansen? This is like when it was off Broadway. So it was like a really long time ago. And I'm like, no, what's that? She's like, I think it's next year's Hamilton. So then I'm driving to school like
it was
2 days later. And the same radio thing is on because they're talking about Dear Evan Hansen. And I literally missed the turn to go to school because I'm listening so deep into this radio broadcast about Dear Evan Hansen because I wanted to know what it was about. And I like heard a little bit about it, like they didn't go much into it. So then I come home and I'm like, hey, I heard about Dear Evan Hansen today. And my mom's like, yeah? And I'm like, yeah, it sounds interesting. But then I could literally find nothing about it because like it was brand new off Broadway. And then I like kept following it and like seeing like how much success it was having, and I waited for all the songs to be released, and then it got 11 Tonys, and I'm very proud that I was with it the entire journey.
So people started posting about it on Instagram, and I was like, oh great, a new musical I have to like. Plot twist, it's fantastic. It was one of those things where like I wasn't the first one in like my theater group at school to start listening to it. So basically, I saw it on Instagram. Because apparently I'm a basic hipster. Who should be in the first replacement cast? Thomas Sanders.
Yes. Oh my gosh. I love Thomas Sanders.
He would be very good.
Also,
as Evan.
I don't know if you know who this is. Skylar Astin. You know who that is? He's in Pitch Perfect.
Yeah.
He plays Ben Platt's roommate.
Sure.
Well, I think he'd be really good as Evan Hansen. Or even Jared. Like, he could play either one.
George Salazar.
Or Jared.
Yeah. And is Dear Evan Hansen important?
Because it teaches you things.
It teaches you sad things.
It teaches you about suicide, mental disorders, and not to lie because you will ruin everyone's lives.
Don't lie, kids. Dear Evan Hansen is important because no one deserves to be forgotten.
No one deserves to fade away.
No one. It's really sad.
I watched the bootleg and I cried. Yeah. You told me about it. She told me there was a bootleg.
I was like, hey buddy,
I gave my computer a lot of viruses trying to get to this bootleg. I didn't care. I was like, Mom, you gotta fix the computer. She's like, why?
That's really and weird. I watched it on my phone.
And I was like, because I had to watch Dear Evan Hansen.
Rate out of 10 stars is the last one. Question 27. Rated out of 10 stars.
10.
11. Just kidding, 10. I do like it, but it has a problem. It's not getting 11 because of the fans.
And the cut songs that should be in it.
Yeah!
Alright.
That's it.
Olivia and Lily, out.